Hello, everyone. Welcome back to Less Code, More Power. We have an amazing show for you today. We have Joe Camp, who's going to be talking all about how you can switch your career to the Power Platform. Stay tuned. Hello, everyone. Welcome back to Less Code, More Power. I'm Sarah Critchley, and I'm joined by my amazing co-host, Dona Sarah. So one of the things that is so important is talking about how you can switch your career to the Power Platform. And we have the best guest on to be able to really tell you an amazing story, his own personal experience. Joe, welcome to the show.
Thanks, Sarah, and thanks, Dona. Real quick on my story. I was in financial services for a long time, 17, 18 years, worked for a local bank. And then the bank fell on some hard times, which a lot of banks did in 2007, 2008. And my role was eliminated. And I'm trying to figure out what to do, where to go, what we needed to do. At the time, there really were not a lot of roles in the banking industry because there was a big consolidation going on. So it was time for me to try to figure out, do I move back to the East Coast? I currently live on the West Coast. East Coast is where I'm from and my wife is from. Or do we stay where we are and pivot into something different? And part of that conversation was my wife told me, I like it here where we live, which is in Seattle. You need to figure out how we can stay. So with that and with the idea of pivoting, I had a conversation with a friend of mine, one of my neighbors who worked at Microsoft. And through conversations, a number of different conversations, I was hired to work for him as a vendor, which then became a full-time employee role. And the role was one where it was more community-oriented, program-oriented, business analyst-oriented. And some of that was applicable to what I used to do, which was very finance, a lot of playing around with spreadsheets, a lot of trying to figure out how to maximize return on investment and some other stuff. To more relationship management and building internal and external relationships, as well as some projects and planning and that sort of thing. So big pivot, but some of the things that I used to do were applicable. And then a lot of other stuff I was able to learn. So it was really cool. Still learning the tech part of the role and being in tech and continuously challenged by my manager, who won't be named.
You know, that must have been really tough, Joe, like kind of just to kind of go into that point, essentially, like your job didn't exist, right, in your original kind of company. Like, that must have been a pretty tough time for you, like kind of, because it's easy for us to talk about in retrospect, right, because like you're kind of okay, you know, you've landed on your feet sort of thing. Mm-hmm. But you know, that must have been tough.
Yes, it was scary. You know, you're used to having a consistent income coming in, and that didn't happen. I had a severance package, but you know, obviously, you're kind of limited. And honestly, it took, I think it was 6 months. I was out of work for about eight months. I was out of work, and looking and trying to figure out what to do, and it was pretty darn scary. Fortunately, I had a good support system with my family and my immediate family, and then my parents and others, and as well as the friends around me, but also was able to build a pretty good network of contacts. And at the time, you know, LinkedIn was there, but it wasn't really as prevalent as it is now, and the ability to build those online networks and that online networking system. But fortunately, yeah, I mean, it was scary for sure. But I think what helped was being willing to change, being open to change, being willing to walk into something that you don't know a heck of a lot about, but you're willing to learn and want to learn, and maybe even take a pay cut a little bit. you know that in the end, it'll make it, you'll make yourself whole, for lack of a better way to say it, in the end. So yeah, it was scary, but the networking was huge.
I think a lot of people are going to be able to resonate with that. So if you're watching and like this has kind of happened to you, right? Like it, you know, we get it, right? I think everyone on the call today has had this kind of like experience. And I think that it's important to remember that, you know, Joe, you really touched on something, right? The willingness to be open to other opportunities and to also know that it's going to be okay, right? So before we get into some of the things that you wanted to show us, could you just share a little bit about some of the amazing stuff you've been doing recently? Because you've created a course on Udacity, all this kind of stuff, right? There's a lot of things that you've been doing.
Yeah, and so, and this is a bit self-serving, but it's not intended to be that way. And the self-serving part is because my manager is the other person on this on this talk. But the Udacity course was really just a real quick background. So I had been in this role as part of the Power Platform, Power Apps team that Donna's running since July, and didn't know a ton about Power Apps, played with it a little bit, but not a lot, but a lot of willingness to grow and willingness to learn. And I think, you know, Donna took a chance on me. So thank you. And hopefully I'm doing what she's expecting of me. Some of the things that we're working on, you know, it's trying to figure out how to take Power Apps and show people like me that are not tech oriented, don't have a comp sci degree, don't know how to code. But I played around with Word and played around with PowerPoint and with Excel, a lot of Excel, and then translate some of those skills into building apps. And so part of that, into what you touched on with this Udacity course that we built, that Donna drove, and the team that I'm on with, that include Greg Holman and Homolo Mumbati, they did a ton of the work. You know, and I was kind of the guinea pig, and then it was like, all right, so if Joe can figure this out, then I think we're working down the right path, right?
the proper term for that is like tester or QA analyst.
Yeah, that's a better descriptor for sure. But yeah, it's a really cool course. It goes into, you know, how you build out an environment first of all, and then going through step by step on building an app. And how you can craft that app or build that app to however way you want it to look. And then you pull in some AI, which the AI is really cool. I mean, you know, even somebody that's not super geeky, I mean, the AI stuff was really, I mean, I even geeked out a lot about it because I was like sending texts to Donna and to other guys and other folks on the team. Like, I did this with the AI and this is so cool. I mean, this is going to be like the best party trick in the world when I go out and have, when we're able to have, you know, parties again. Hopefully that'll happen soon. But yeah, so that, and then also looking at the job market for Power Apps and Power Platform. And, you know, one of the things that's really been interesting over since, I guess, starting in November, I started looking at the numbers in September, but starting in November, December, and into this month, what's really been interesting are the number of large, I guess I'll say large, management consulting firms that are looking for people, that have Power Apps, Power Platform skill sets. And these are the Deloitte's, the Ernst & Young's, the Accenture's, KPMG, Hitachi. Some of these are focused really on tech, but then also they're focused on kind of business oriented roles. And I think from my perspective, I'm looking at this, I'm thinking, all right, these are all really smart people. They typically be looking at things in the future, and what we're seeing is that they are looking at their customers' expectations down the road. And pulling these people in will help meet those expectations. And so to me, it's kind of like this, like a funnel, right? And so you've got the tech people up at the very top, and then you've got the management people, the management consulting folks that are looking to build out their group of people that are going to be driving Power Apps and Power Platform, because their customers are going to look for it. And then at some point, the customers are going to say, hey, wait a minute, we can learn internally how to do this. And so then this long base of people that are finance people, that are accountants, that are marketing people, that are HR folks are going to learn this. And it's like, this is so cool that we are helping people be more productive and reduce process flow to be, you know, more effective and more efficient in their roles.
Giving them opportunities, that's the biggest thing, right? So yeah. This has honestly been so great. Could you take a couple minutes? I want you to show the audience, right, especially based on what you said about your story, where you've come from. Can you just take the next few minutes to show the audience what you've been able to make?
Yeah, sure. So this is a power app that I built. It's like an inventory tracking power app. And this is based off of really something that in a role that I used to have, I would have loved to have had this thing where I was in charge of all the swag that we had for the team we were on when we would go to conferences. And this tracks all that swag. And this is just the splash page, and it's tied to an Excel data. It's tied to an Excel spreadsheet, which pulls information in and out. And then there's a ability that you can go in and switch this page to another page that you can add and subtract the pieces of inventory as you use them. And now everybody on the team knows what's going on, what we have in inventory, what we don't have in inventory. There's a couple of other screens that show where the inventory is allocated to, like say for example this first top one where I have 14, I think that maybe 26 of those were allocated towards fictitiously towards Ignite, and you know, it just makes things a lot simpler and a lot easier, and it was pretty easy to get all that done. I think I did it in like a day or less than a day when I first started learning how to play with these things. So yeah, it's pretty cool.
This is amazing. I always love to use the term rapid application development. It has a lot of different meanings, especially from the development world, but I really do think this technology brings it to life, right? Like you said, you've been able to make this in less than a day.
Yeah.
So that's amazing. So given everything, like I have so many questions, but I'm trying to hold back. So given everything you've said and everything, what's your message to people, Joe? What do you want the homework to be for the episode today?
So from my perspective, I think the homework is twofold. One, check out our Udacity course. It's free. It'll take you, I don't know, depending on how quickly you work, 8 to 10 hours to do. You can do it over 2 weekends. And I think you'll really get a lot out of it. Second, for those who are thinking about moving to a different role or have an interest in looking at some other opportunities, on LinkedIn, we have a Power Platform job board. It's private. I'm one of the admins, and I'll add you in. You can just look me up, Joe Camp, and then just message me, or you can request to become a member. We have like 600, close to 700 people on there that include recruiters. They're people globally. We post jobs, job descriptions as we get them. We've been getting a ton lately. Then I'll put some posts in there myself on what I see within LinkedIn. And I think it's a great opportunity, and we'd love to have you participate and look and see what we're doing.
Brilliant. Those are two amazing pieces of homework. So you heard it here, everyone. For those of you watching, if you're interested in a job in Power Platform, please do check out the links below that we'll put in the description, and also check out that course as well. Like Joe says, you know, you can complete that in a couple of weeks, and that's, you know, your knowledge will go from zero if you don't know anything about Power Platform to knowing so much to be able to build an app like you've seen today. So thank you so much for your time today, Joe. Like, it's been amazing to have you as a guest on the show.
Thank you very much, Sarah. And thank you, Donna. This has been my pleasure. Greatly appreciate it.
Brilliant. So thanks, everyone. Thanks for those of you who have been watching today. Like I said, check out the links below. And remember, less code, more power.